let's assume that we, that is India, find ourselves in a situation where we have to launch a nuclear weapon either out of retaliation against an aggressor or to protect ourselves from a credible threat. How would Delhi do that? Who would launch the weapon? And who would take the final call? So the question that needs to be asked is, what's the protocol for launching a nuclear attack? To begin with, let's take a brief look at a nuclear program. Post the loss of 1962 war with China, India started working on construction of a nuclear weapon and design work began under Dr. Homi Bhabha in the year 1965. It is strongly believed that India had a nuclear stockpile by the end of 1967. But the first test was conducted in the year 1974, nicknamed Smiling Buddha, under the Prime Minister Indira Gandhi. The second set of tests were conducted in 1998, called Pokhran 2, under the leadership of Prime Minister Vajpayee. In this test, India successfully launched and tested 5 nuclear bombs and officially declared itself as a nuclear state. In 2003, India set up a nuclear command authority for command and control of nuclear weapons in India. Nuclear Command Authority is the sole authority on nuclear weapons in India. It is headed by the sitting Prime Minister and consists of 3 main committees: an Executive Council, a Political Council, and a Strategic Forces Command. The Political Council has the power to decide on whether to launch a nuclear attack or not. It is headed by the Prime Minister, the only officially disclosed member of the Council. Speculations have it that the members of Cabinet Committee on Security could also be part of this Council, like Home Minister, Defence Minister, and External Affairs Minister. The Executive Council is headed by a National Security Advisor, again, the only officially disclosed member of the Council. Experts believe that heads of intelligence agencies like RAW, IB, and Chairman of Chief of Staff's Committee of Three Services, along with the members of scientific community related to nuclear weapons like DRDO, could also be members of this Council. Strategic Forces Command is a tri-service command, constituting of Army, Navy, and Air Force, and will act as operational wing of NCA. It will have its own Commander-in-Chief who will be reporting to Chairman of Chiefs of Staff Committee. The power to launch a nuclear attack will be held solely with Political Council by studying the input given by the Executive Council, and the responsibility of carrying out that attack will be held with Strategic Forces Command. Once the NCA has given an order to launch a nuclear weapon, it's up to the Strategic Forces Command to decide on the exact location, type of delivery, and the time. The Strategic Forces Command has at its disposal 3 types of attack options. 1. Air-based nuclear weapons, which would be carried by either Mirage or Jaguar jets. The new Rafale aircrafts to be included in the Air Force are also capable of delivering nuclear weapons. Land-based ballistic missiles. India has a range of domestically developed missile categories which are capable of carrying a nuclear payload, such as Prithvi range of missiles, Agni range of missiles, and Surya. Sea-based ballistic missiles. India has a nuclear capable submarine called INS Arihant, which can deliver a nuclear weapon from the sea. India has also recently domestically built and launched a nuclear capable submarine called INS Aridhaman. The Navy can launch nuclear weapons from a destroyer called INS Rajput and a Sukanya class patrol craft called INS Subhadra. The weapons that can be used on these submarines and ships to carry a nuclear payload are Dhanush, Sagarika, and K4 missiles. The Strategic Forces Command is also under the process of developing its own fleet to deliver a nuclear payload as and when asked for, and has requested the government for 40 fighter jets to be procured only for this purpose. Strategic Forces Command at present relies on excellent coordination between the Air Force, Army, and Navy when it's called for duty. So in a nutshell, the ultimate power to sanction a nuclear attack is held with the Prime Minister of India, and he can decide to launch or not to launch against all the recommendations. So that's all from Third Opinion this time, guys. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment. Until next time, take care.